In this video, I'll walk you through how I retouch my photos from start to finish using Alien Skin Exposure X2. Welcome back everybody to The Breakdown. I'm Miguel Quiles. I'm going to walk you through a simple way to retouch your Sony RAW files using Alien Skin's Exposure X2 software. For those of you who aren't familiar with the program, it's a non-destructive RAW editing software that allows you to organize and edit your images completely within the program or as a plugin that's compatible with Photoshop and Lightroom. If you want to follow along and retouch your own images, you can download a free trial of the software over on their website at alienskin.com. Before we get started, let me give you a brief rundown on the various panels found within the program. To begin, you'll want to find your images on your computer within the Folders tab. Since I often shoot tethered using Capture One, all of the images are directly saved onto my computer where I can quickly find them within Exposure. In the middle column of the program, you'll see all of the images within that folder. You can also use the slider at the top of the panel to make your thumbnails bigger or smaller. As you scroll through the images, you can hover over them to see a dialog window that displays all of the metadata for each image. As you browse through each image, you can click on the stars that appear below each shot to give it a rating. This will narrow things down so that you can filter out and see only the images that you rated and are considering for retouching. Now that I've rated a few images, I can click on the filter bar below to see my favorites. Now, looking at these, I see the image I want to retouch, so I double-click to expand it and begin working. I often begin my workflow by selecting a preset in the left side panel. There are over 500 presets available in both black and white or color that can be fine-tuned to give you the look you want for your images. By clicking on the arrow to expand each of the categories, you can hover over the thumbnails to see a preview of what each of the presets will do to your image. Once you've found the preset you like, simply click to select it. You can also click on the star in the top corner of the thumbnail to save it to your Favorites tab, which can be seen at the top of the Presets panel for quick access in the future. For this image, I've chosen the Kodak Portra 400 VC preset. It keeps my skin tones looking good and adds a beautiful richness to the overall color of the image. With the preset applied, I can now customize it to get the exact look that I want by adjusting the image via the panel on the right. Before I do that, I'm going to click on these triangles to minimize the other panels so I can maximize the size of the image on the screen. Now, you'll notice that you have a histogram panel up top where you can view your overall exposure. Clicking on the triangles in either corner will show you if you're clipping your highlights or shadows. Any areas that you see that are highlighted mean that you've lost detail at the pixel level by either over or underexposing your shot. You can see by the blue highlighted area that we've lost some detail in the shadow area of her hair, but that's okay since there's nothing back there that I really want the viewer to look at anyway. Moving right along, the first tab we're going to work on is the Basic tab. Here we can make overall adjustments to our white balance, as well as our exposure, clarity, and saturation. I'm going to tweak the white balance to warm it up a bit and give her skin tone and hair a richer color. I'm happy with the exposure, so I won't adjust that, but I will add some contrast to the image. Right around 5 looks good to me. The last thing I typically do in this tab is to adjust the clarity. For portraits, I tend to go somewhere between 1 and 5, since going much higher than that will usually give the image a really highly processed look. For this image, I'll leave it at 1 and close out the panel. The Detail tab will allow you to apply sharpening as well as noise reduction to your image. You can manually adjust all of the parameters here, but we'll leave this one for now since I don't need these settings for this particular image. The Color tab allows you to make additional adjustments to your image by either applying a preset or by manually adjusting the sliders. You can even target specific colors in the Color Saturation section, but again, I won't need to adjust these as I'm more than happy with the colors the preset automatically applied. The same can be said of the Tone Curves tab for this image, where you can tweak the tones and contrast of your image even further. We'll skip that and go to the Vignette tab. Here I can customize my vignette to look exactly the way I want it to look. I'm going to click on the preset drop-down menu and select Subtle Black for this image. I'll increase the size of this vignette manually by moving the slider over to 21. Now that we've applied this vignette, we'll go ahead and we'll move over to the Overlays tab. The Overlays tab allows you to apply borders, light effects, and textures to your images. They're a lot of fun to play around with and add a creative touch to your images. I won't be applying any to this image, but you definitely want to explore this tab to see if some of the effects might make your images more interesting. The next area we will adjust is the Focus tab. For my portraits, I use the preset Sharpen, Low Radius, 25. You'll notice that this preset adds a lot of sharpness to the image, more than what I would actually want, but as you can do with every other preset, you can adjust the sliders to get the exact look you want. I'm going to bring down the amount to around 5.36 and have the radius match that number as well. You'll want to tweak this setting for each and every one of your portraits, as some may need more or less sharpening. The final tab I will make adjustments to is the grain tab. Now, I apply grain to almost every single one of my images to give it a more pleasing final look. I typically choose the preset regular grain 25% and manually adjust it to taste. You can customize the look of the grain within your shadows, midtones, and highlights to give your image a more film-like look. I'm going to reduce the shadows and midtones to 25% and the highlights down to 8%. I'm also going to adjust the roughness of the grain down to 15. This gives a slight amount of grain and it won't take away from the overall sharpness of the image. Now that I have my preset looking the way I want it, I can begin my retouching. Right below the histogram tab, you'll see two icons. One is a band-aid and the other a brush. We're going to eventually use both here, but we'll begin by clicking the band-aid icon. Within this window, I can use the healing brush or clone stamp tools to remove blemishes and reduce other distractions throughout the image. You can adjust the size, the feather, the opacity for these two tools so that the adjustments blend nicely with your image. All I do is simply brush over the area that I want to heal, then a selection is made and I'm able to move it around to sample other parts of the image to heal the selected area. You want to make sure you move the selection to an area that is close to the area you're trying to heal, and that way you can retain the same texture and end up with a higher quality result. Finally, it's time to apply some effects via the brush tool. The first thing I do with my portrait is to begin by dodging and burning. I'll select the dodge tool and brush over the areas of the image that I want to lighten. I tend to dodge over the forehead, nose line, chin, as well as the natural highlights on the lips. I also lighten the shadows underneath the eye to give a fresher appearance, as well as the space between the eye and the eyebrows. Another thing I often dodge are the highlights within the hair. Noelle has awesome hair with a lot of natural highlights, so I simply brush over the areas to give them a bit more shine. After I'm done dodging the image, I go over to the burn tool. This will basically darken selected parts of your image by brushing over it, just like it does with the dodge tool. For portraits, I typically use the tool to darken the eyebrows, as well as around the iris, and in the dark areas of the hair to add more texture and dimensionality. The last thing I'll do is to use the Enhance Iris preset. With that selected, I simply brush within the iris to bring out the detail. Don't go too far with this. You want to add just a hint of detail and keep things looking realistic. I've completed all of my adjustments and now I'm ready to export this file and share it with the world. Simply right-click on the file and choose Export. A new window will open up and allow you to select where you want to save your image, how you want to name it, what format and size to save it in, as well as choosing to include your metadata. Once you've finished here, simply click Export and you're all set. If you followed along, I would love to see your results of using this process with your own image. If you're on Facebook, join my group and share your images by going to facebook.com/groups/Sony Alpha Tips. Be sure to include your camera and lens combo along with the presets you used. Thanks for joining me today on Adorama TV. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV for more amazing videos. Just click on the link below and let us know what you think. Like, comment, and share this video. And don't forget to visit the Adorama Learning Center for lots of great tips and tricks. Thanks again, and I'll see you on the next episode of The Breakdown. Bye, everyone.